Nouveaux talents. I hear your steps. Your feet cast echoes among the rock and vegetation. Do not back from me. I see you, small creature. You understand me in this dark, yes. Good. You are mortal, human. I have not had a human come to me for ages. Tell me, have you come merely for the sake of ignorance? Or innocence? Or is there a purpose to this interruption of my slumbers? Will you enter in a most familiar fashion? When I raised my bowed low in my presence. This shows some respect on your part. Something my last visitor had very little of. You know something of me, and yet you come here shaking in your boots, frightened at my gaze. You claim not to be frightened, oh human. I know fear when I see it. But I can see you did not come here for fear. You came for something else. If it is treasure you seek, you will be disappointed. No, little mortal. No amount of gold, silver or gems do I possess. And if indeed that is what you came for, then I highly suggest you leave with all haste. I do not take all too kindly to beggars and thieves. Speak clearly to me. Tell me your purpose here. That's better. I see you move fully in the light. You are no person of wealth. You're close. clothes caked in mud, the soot of hours of walking upon your feet. You tremble so fiercely, human. Speak quickly to me. Tell me what it is you are here for, and I will do my best to supply you so that you may leave me in peace. You ask me why I do not kill you where you stand. Let us be clear, I am not like other dragons. No. I serve a purpose. I do not live merely to kill. You have come to me seeking knowledge. Interesting. Who told you that I would be any great source for knowledge? Your teacher. Was he a nobleman? Was he a wise man? Did he tell you to come here in hopes that I would have some sort of knowledge that you seek? Or was it on a fool's errand that you were sent to me? Interesting. He was no nobleman. Merely teacher of common magic. Well, the last person who came to me seeking such knowledge is long since dead. But he was no peasant, no commoner. He was a king. Why should I help you? Why should I give you an inkling of my knowledge? Why should I open my mind to you? The king who came to me was wealthy. Not in gold or silver, no, but he gave me his library, and by his side I studied and I guarded his realm. The ruler before him, she was a wise queen, and I taught her the ways of her fathers and her father. In return, she gave me the safety of these lands, which I could retreat to whenever I saw fit. What have you to trade, little human, lower than dust? And what if your trade displeases me? Do you think, merely because you wish to know knowledge, that you are safe? Like any other beast, I hunger, and it has been a while since my last meal. Why shouldn't I just eat you now and save myself the trouble? You bring me a gift. What is this? Is that you are? Raise it up. Show me what I may see. This book. What is its contents? A philosophy, science, the common literature, poetry, or mathematics. What knowledge does it hold? I see. Your gift, please. When I spoke before of treasure and it not being of gold, I spoke more of the treasure of my knowledge, of which you seem to be aware. You wish to learn magic. I can help you. This book pleases me, for I do not delve into the vain need of gold or of gems or of the countless rubies and emeralds dug beneath the earth. No. What could gold teach me that words or written language could not? Gold may glitter, but it holds no heart. It gains no spirit of life. The written word, the spoken language, knowledge of ages, therein lies true treasure. And there I shall teach you. I will teach you the magic of dragons. Vumbai Varsin in my tongue, dragon's breath. For a dragon's breath speaks more than flame. We speak life. I shall. Return to me daily, from morning till dusk. Bring parchment, ink, and pen, food for yourself, for my studies are vigorous. I expect you to return tomorrow, bright and early. Your thanks and your praise are not necessary. You seem an eager mind, a mind like my own. But your thanks is well appreciated. As I said, return to me tomorrow. Introduction is appropriate if you are to be my pupil. But not today. Return to me tomorrow. Let us see how well you study under my observation, under my teaching, and I will judge whether you are worthy enough to know. Until then, my stupid.